We just cut out for no goddamn reason at all.
Nigga!
God damn! Anyways, I got interrupted, bro. I got interrupted. Let me talk about what I completely lost everything. I don't know how it happened, but it just happened right now, bro. So, today, guys, I want to talk about a topic that's been bothering me since, God, the past few years. The past few goddamn years of people complaining and bitching about how our generation is the most sensitive generation here. Blah, blah, blah. This and that. You know what? I think I gotta go to explain that shit. Because people don't seem to get the memo that some of y'all don't make any sense. Some of y'all really don't make any sense at all. Nah, really. You really do not make sense. So let's talk about the fact that you guys started, then once you're getting called out for your bad behavior, then you're getting mad and bent out of shape about it. So I'm gonna finish this match first. Alright, so I wanted to know why people keep talking about how sensitive the generation is, or Generation Z in general. So, as I said before, most of you guys don't have the reserved right to call people out for sensitivity when you guys got mad when you got it taken away from you, like taking candy from a baby. So, these exact same people are talking about how you shouldn't be apologizing and all this, but yet you're the type of people who make all of us uncomfortable, force us to not act like ourselves, or most of these people are talking about sensitivity, but they are the exact same individuals who do the exact same shit that we do. So Generation Z may be known as the most sensitive generation to them, but I did want to make sure and make it clear that you are the exact same people that picked and bullied on everyone else who wasn't able to defend themselves against you. Number one, let's start off with some actual points here. Point one would be the racism. Clearly, the racism was so strong back then, it was just so boring. Let's start off with the fact that racist comedy is the most boring comedy on the planet. Unless if you make it about everyone. Guess what these dumbass comedians did? Instead of making it about everyone, right? Instead of making it about everyone, they make it about three races: Mexican, Asian, and Black. So the reason why also comedy, or racist comedy, excuse me, died out is because people, or at least one in particular race, wanted to disclude themselves as they are, again, there is a superiority factor. So they wanted to include themselves as a superior race that says, I don't have any issues, there's nothing wrong with me, I'm the most perfect person on the planet. So let me explain something about the sensitive comedy that we have nowadays and the racist comedy back then. Now, racist comedy completely was overused. Too boring, right? Now, these people would do it constantly to the point where it's actually downright fucking insulting. Instead of making it comedy, it was more of an insult type of thing. So we look back at this as one of the worst years of my lifetime. In fact, I'm glad that on that time period, I was not on the internet. I was too busy focusing on being a kid, being a child, being someone that needs to focus on kid stuff. Not playing them again, but most of these people would complain, bitch and moan constantly, but never would understand that their way of living was very much flawed. It was actually annoying to even hear them talk about racism constantly. Now, the gamers that keep going on about racism and it not needing to be something that was that serious, it's just, remember, the one type of gamer that you should always blame is nice guy gamers. Let's get this match over with. And these people are known as nice guy gamers. Who the fuck would you think I would not blame? Now, let's talk about how nice guy gamers always happen to mess something up. Now, you see, most nice guy gamers are very socially awkward, weird, very entitled, and they're the most piece of shit type of people you'll come across every day. So The reason why people say this generation is sensitive is because they're tired of your shit. But other than that, people want you to just sit there, tolerate it, just tolerate the racist crap, tolerate the xenophobia, tolerate all of this, blah, 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 same old, disrespect, all the damn time. That's what they want you to tolerate, by the way. Now, let's get this show on the road as well, not playing him again. And these dudes really be deciding what people should be doing. They be always trying to say, don't be sensitive to this, don't be sensitive to that, it's just a video game. But these people make fun of people's dead pops, like, you know, a certain somebody. Anyways, as I said before, these nice guy gamers ass dudes, you know what I'm talking about. These nice guy gamers always be saying, don't take things seriously, it's just a video game. But say, for example, these types of dudes can make fun of someone's dead pops. Well, Neusxanity, what do you mean by someone's dead pops? Okay, let me start off with one thing for sure. Someone's dead pops, as in Jacksepticeye's dad. Has anyone been seeing those recent memes surfacing around? You know what I'm saying? Constantly, every day? I see them every day on Reddit. Every damn time. And these piece of shit little kids, the same people that you guys look up to, right? Say, like, nice guy gamers don't take anything seriously. They don't take death seriously. They don't take anything seriously. So, nice guy gamers will make fun of your dad regardless if he died or not, because they don't give a damn. They don't give a damn if he's dead. They don't give a damn if he's under the ground. They don't give a damn. They don't give a damn if he's 5 feet under. You know what I mean? It's just like, these guys suck. For two reasons. One, for starters, is that they literally think that they can disrespect everyone they go around. See, these guys have been around since the late 2000s, disrespecting people, disrespecting others in general. But you know what's funny? You look up to them, you think of their composed attitude as a good thing, but see, that composure turns into recklessness and disrespect. So, no. Alright, this pussy is dead. This pussy is dead, you punk ass nigga! Bitch ass nigga! Dude, we didn't take that! You suck! You fucking punk ass nigga! You suck! Bitch ass nigga! Punk ass bitch! Woo! You're going viral for that shit, punk ass nigga! Why did you fucking taunt me like that, bitch? Anyway, let's keep this shit going. Now I'm hyped. These dudes really be thinking that they're so good with getting away with things because the media allows them to. Listen, just because you think that you can mess with people and troll them online and do all that, let me make something clear to you. This lifestyle that we're all living is kind of great to me, because back then, if I was autistic, right, if there was someone with a disability, I remember them getting blasted for that disability. Does that make any sense? Like, I remember them trying to come out and be like, hey, I have autism, and they're like, oh, you have autism, you're a retard, or something like that. So yeah, I mean, you have to really understand. Oh my god, dude. Like, I remember friends that had autism getting bullied like crazy, and that was like upsetting. After they admitted it, they end up getting bullied by them online. And you know what's funny? 4chan is the prime example of why that type of humor is disgusting and exists still over there. So like I said before, these gamers be trying to act like people are being too sensitive. As I said before again. Because later on in life, they'll understand that being this way and having less of a intolerable humor, because I can't tolerate that stuff too. I remember when people would get hate mail just for being like a character with darker skin tone, as I said before, maybe. A character with darker skin tone, for crying out loud. Like my Alyssa that I have. And they'll automatically think you're black or Mexican. They'll start making over-the-border jokes and all that crap. You know, typical nice guy gamer crap. That's why I don't like nice guy gamers, because I have friends that were personally nice guy gamers myself. And that's why I stopped messing with them, because all these toxic people actually ended up to be better people. That's what's crazy. All these nice guy gamers, they ended up being incels, bro. Like, I know people who are incels until this very day. Who start disrespecting people, making slurs, you know, the typical bigot type of thing. And it's just like, damn, you guys are gonna really say that? And it's just like, why? Why would you do that? So I was thinking about it, and I stopped messing with a couple of people because of that, that mentality. Like, I don't mess with people like that anymore, because it's just... Like, I can't stand that, man. I can't stand the disrespect, and I can't stand someone disrespecting someone for different things than them. If this was PewDiePie, no one would be making fun of him. But Jacksepticeye, yes, let's make fun of him. Let's make fun of his dad dying. Let's make fun of everything. But see, these people don't deserve any respect. Like, you have to understand, they make fun of people for being sensitive, but yet they're sensitive themselves when someone calls them out. They'll start, I remember a time when someone was about to beat someone's ass for, like, let me recall it. The memory is fuzzy after all.
Hold on.
Yeah, I'm gonna stop it right here. Let me say this. The dude, this was a friend of mine that I used to hang out with. We don't hang out anymore. We don't even fuck with each other. This dude would think that it would be okay to make all these racial slurs and all that. At one point, this was someone of my own color and descent. This guy got roasted to oblivion. My friend, my so-called was past tense friend, got roasted to oblivion because he was being a bigot towards some Asian people. So I stopped talking for a moment because I wasn't gonna feel like talking at all because I was eating my food, my lunch food. And then this idiot, man, let me tell you, he kept talking about how Asians are this, Asians are that, that's why Asians are so flat. And it's just like, okay, all right, you're gonna get yourself in trouble. And one of the wannabe cool kids, as I like to call them, caught him saying that, and one of them roasted him on his appearance and how he looked like an out-of-the-closet vampire. This was someone who was Mexican, by the way, and then he said something like, "Go back to the border, you stupid bitch. You know, he called him a beaner. He said, "You beaner, go back to the border, you stupid bitch." And he's like, "What'd you say?" He smacked the shit out of my friend so fucking hard that he was taken aback by it. He's like, he started fucking crying. And it's just like, I told you that humor wasn't gonna work. At one point, we had a fight with each other. Well, not a physical one, but we had a fight with each other. So he couldn't handle it that I was spitting some facts that humor is not gonna fly in a couple of years. The dude was like, "Yes, it will. It's gonna fly. People are gonna have to understand that being this way is funny and it's fun." And so, like, "You're being ignorant, though. There's a difference. You're being ignorant." He's like, "You're being ignorant. You don't understand that racism is cool. That's what you guys don't understand. God damn, some of you old black people need to stop being so uptight about things." I'm like, "Excuse me?" Everyone in my group was like, "Whoa, what the fuck?" And then they all got on him. And he's like, "Fine, fuck you guys. I'm not gonna be your friends anymore." Until, like, the whole year, that guy sat by himself. And then, like, months later, he made a friend of his own that was just like him. And after that, they got jumped constantly, because they would always be picking fights with people for no reason. And the thing is, the guy really thought it was okay to continuously make racist humor over and over again. But the thing is, the point of it, more likely, is like, he kept doing the same thing over and over again. That's why racist humor became so dry. It's because people keep doing the same thing over and over again. It's just like, what are you doing? Why do you keep doing that? It's not even funny. Like, you're unfunny as fuck. And I'm sitting here, bro. I'm sitting here just allowing it to happen. Sometimes he would look at me and I would just ignore him. I could tell he's looking at me from a distance, and I would just go on with my day. The whole school year, we didn't even talk. But the point is of this is that I knew that one day, finally, people like me are going to be able to come out and be myself. For now, it's just bigotry at its finest. And no one understands that type of humor that you guys want so bad. You don't understand the whole Hitler thing. The whole Hitler thing and the whole racist humor. You guys, there's only one race to blame, and I'm sorry, I'm gonna straight up say this. It's mainly white people. Listen, I don't hate white people. I never will hate you guys. I never will hate who you are. I will never hate that you are someone who may have done things in the past that was bad. But I will say this, the only reason why racist humor was damaged because white people were constantly, like, not including themselves. They thought of their race as the more superior adversary to everyone else. The superior person, the superior everything. So it was just like, we gotta get rid of it. If you can't make fun of yourself too, then it's a problem. Like, why was the racist humor only directed towards three races and not another one? If it is directed towards everyone and saying how bad both humans are, as in general, we would totally have racist humor here today. And everyone would not be upset about it, but you guys messed it up. You gotta take responsibility for that. You can't just be blaming black people, you can't be blaming Mexicans, Asians, and saying that they're sensitive. Listen, bro, the reason why I'm telling you this right now is because if you did racist humor correctly, right? If you did racist humor correctly, it would still be here today. And on top of that, the nice guy gamers wouldn't have been able to keep doing it over and over again until their brains burnt out of racist jokes. But sadly, that race in particular messed it up for everyone. And you guys just need to adapt. Just as nice guy gamers tell other people to adapt, you need to adapt to a new style of humor. And you need to understand that you can't always have it your way. Anyways, guys, I'm going to end the video here. We're going to keep playing Tekken, and that's it. Bye.